Well, thank you so much for talking to us, Sona Mohapatra, and welcome to India Television. I have to start by asking you, Sona, you know, you've put out a very, very powerful music video out there, you know, for everyone to see on social media. You've put out three of them and, you know, of 30 seconds each, called Ek Din, which you have shot and directed yourself. Mm-hmm. Talk to us about it and what was the reason behind this, because, you know, it sends out such a powerful message.
It's great to be here and great to know that people are listening into what an artist has to say, and it doesn't have to necessarily have to be by talking or preaching or saying too much, because a picture tells a thousand words, to use a cliche. But I was in Bangalore doing my first concert in many, many months, so it was exhilarating to start with, but it was tiring. I'd woken up early morning to take a flight out. And I got to know that I was the first independent artist to be put on the Times Square billboard, you know, and for me, that was a high. And just when I was putting that out as a message of, you know, I also saw that online something had happened, which was this whole pawn racket or whatever, you know.
Yes.
And while I was not tuned into mainstream media and I was not really tuning into the details, so the first thing I realized was somebody else has been arrested. The investigation is going on. Of course, there is this huge debate and discussion that's going to happen around it. But the first thing that I notice is that it has given ammunition to a country and some people, I'm not saying everybody, to suddenly start trolling women and telling, oh, you are from Bollywood or you are from the entertainment industry, so I can take liberty of saying that all of you are like this, all of you are part of this kind of an industry, sleaze. And I know we are on television, so I do not want to put out the words that were put out there. And it got me thinking, saying, one is it infuriated me, but it also made me realize that here is an opportunity for me to say something powerfully without having to tell too many lines for it. And I decided to push my flight by an hour and shoot the set of videos by myself. And what I wanted to put out there was, we need to have a much more nuanced conversation when it comes to even something like the place of porn in society, because there's much more to it than, you know, there's an angle of human trafficking and exploitation at one end. But the other end, which I wanted to stand up for, was there's something called free will and consent. And this should not be an excuse for anybody to now clamp down on the women. The first thing you do is, I don't know why the women are holding the shorter end of the stick all the time. It's like, I haven't caused this issue. I'm not the one pimping out women or whatever else that's happening out there. But again, we are being told our liberties are being questioned. Our freedom is being questioned. What we dress up is becoming suddenly a reason for you to judge me for my character. And I said, okay, to hell with all these feelings, because I had hundreds, millions of them. I was like, there we go all over again. It's so regressive when this, you know, it's like this whole toxic patriarchal, you know, wheel starts all over again. So I just decided to strip down, shoot this video and say that, yeah, it's, and when it's in context, you know, my whole idea was people have to understand context. When it is a heartbreak song and it's this hotel room, and I was like, it's also going to be, I want to do it aesthetically. And you know what the silver lining in this whole conversation is that when I put it out, what's magical is there is a young, vibrant India that is listening in to me as an artist also, who's consistently, you know, trying to say something in with this audiovisual medium, which goes beyond just wanting to make a hit song or wanting to make it about myself and the latest song that I've put out. And I found it so heartening that, you know, from tomorrow, I'm going to start sharing it. Other women started telling me, unbreakable, unbeatable, you're not going to shame us for this, or my body is not a vessel for your shame, or, you know, my body, my choice. And very, you know, and I'm very overwhelmed, you know, at the end of the day, because all day I've been receiving messages, not only from women, from men, young men, because such a young country. And I just feel I have a lot of hope for the coming days, because younger India, which is demographically, I understand 60% of the country, be it in the tier one towns or tier two towns, whatever the classifications are much more hip to what's happening around the world. And they are very aware of the fact that a woman wearing shorts or showing her legs doesn't mean it's a permission to touch her or to slut shame her or to make her feel ashamed about herself. And I just felt, wow, from a time where I have grown up, where just going out for my mother to the Kirana store to pick up Nariyal and Agarbatti meant that somebody would grab me or hurt me because they passed by. I was a Fauji kid. I've grown up around the country. And apart from maybe a very rare Mumbai or a Pune, after 5:36, it just would be miserable to step out. You just feel so unsafe. You just consciously, your hackles go up. But I think that India is changing, you know, because when I go to perform to colleges, Pia, in colleges, right. Like a place like Allahabad, where I went, you know, Heartland. Mm-hmm. I went to NIIT, I think, few years ago, and I saw girls wearing shorts all night. You know, I was thinking this concert is going to get shut down by 8 o'clock. No, but we were in campus. It went on till 12. There was a party and I felt, okay, I'm not talking about this crazy change that might be everywhere, but this change is coming. And as an artist, right. If I can do it time and time again, and it probably provocates and triggers a certain bunch of people into thinking, oh, what's wrong with this woman? Why can't it only be about the music? And in fact, my well-wishers, my own partner, Ram, was like,
yeah.
I don't bring in activism into this. This is a beautiful love song. I said, yeah, right. But guess what? It's a huge opportunity in a country like ours to say something much more powerful. And thank you so much for noticing, because I know my fans have been sending in a lot of love. And, you know, I'm going to start sharing the videos that other women are making as a, you know, reaction to my video.
Absolutely. But I think, but over here, you know what, Sona, like right from the beginning, you know, we have noticed, be it Me Too, be it any other campaign or whatever happens, you are perhaps the only one who stands up and talks about it. You call a spade a spade. But I want to know, in your opinion, why is our society, our film industry so toxic when it comes to this? Because even now women are being targeted. During the Me Too campaign, women were targeted. Men are back to work now. So, you know, where do you think, we are heading?
I think, you know, one is to look at the glass as half full. But I know that the Me Too movement caused a lot of conversation. I myself was punished, you know. I called out Anu Malik in Kailash Kher. Anu Malik is right. After so many women, and that triggered so many women to tell their stories, more than 9 of them. And he's back on television. But I was asked to leave the television show I was hosting. So, you know, yes, that is true. And that was deeply disappointing and heartbreaking at that time. But I also know that, you know, in this last show that my makeup artist came on with me, she works for web series and other shows and other production houses. She's also doing a big Bollywood film. Young girl, 27-year-old.
Right.
She says, Sona, you will not believe what a change few of you made for us. And, you know, it's not only the actors or the faces on the front who faces harassment in the industry. She says, for us as makeup artists, we have to constantly keep, you know, ADs, so many people behind the scenes, will constantly deal with lewd comments and propositions. And there is no system and we don't know where to go and we all navigate it. But now, production houses give us a form with a set of numbers and email IDs saying you can escalate a matter. There is a certain conversation that has happened which has changed the way people are like, you know, so change doesn't happen overnight. But when right. I hear these stories, and this is just an anecdotal one that happened last Sunday when she was doing my makeup. I was like, it's all been worth it, you know, being kicked out of that show, being felt that I'll be out of work, being called a troublemaker and controversial. And somehow, you know, you just carry this label thinking you'll try and be brave. But sometimes it's so exhausting. You feel, oh my God, is it worth it? Because seems to be that even I don't even seem to have other women who back it. I don't seem to have anybody who reaches out except for a rare few. So you sometimes do question yourself and then you feel, okay, now this is my thing to do. I'm not going to let go of it. And my audience is rewarding me. I was one of the first artists to go back on stage to sing what I do best, you know. So I think we're living in much better times. That the fact that we're having this conversation, that a big media outlet even notice that, okay, this artist is not just about, is doing things and doing it consistently. I'm going to stand for it no matter how inconvenient it is, you know.